What up, peeps? Tony Baker here, back for another movie review. This time, I'm reviewing First Man, starring Ryan Gosling and Claire Foy. Claire Foy, man, they've been really shoving her down our throats lately. Now, Claire is known for the show The Crown, and I guess you can usually tell when somebody's doing really good on the show, because then you see them in mad movies all of a sudden with, like, big lead roles. So it's like, who's Claire Foy? Because I've never seen The Crown. She got big eyes, though. I know that much. She got huge, soulful eyes, like she's alive in those eyes. The First Man, man, it's about Neil Armstrong and the moon landing. Ryan Gosling plays Neil Armstrong, and it's directed by Damien Chazelle, who did La La Land and Whiplash. I was in Whiplash, but my part was cut. I just wanted to throw that in there. But Damien himself emailed me to give me the bad news, which I appreciated, so I wouldn't show up to the premiere and be like, because I've heard stories, actors show up to the premiere and they like, my scene wasn't even, he saved me the trouble, I was like. Cause I don't think I was going to the premiere anyway, but it, had I went, and I'm like, I'm cut? Cause I had lines. Just need to hear no idea, man. Damien's on the roll though. Whiplash did well. La La Land did exceptionally well. And it was like, yo, let's get Ryan back together. You know what I'm saying? Let's do this again. I'm a fan of Ryan Gosling, man. He's one of my favorite cats out here doing it. I've always been in astronomy, you know what I'm saying? The moon landing, did it really happen? I don't know. We'll ask Kenan Baker on that one, on the conspiracy theories. But did they really go? I used to think they really didn't go because they never went back. Like, you know what I'm saying? I figure if you go once, then you start bringing parts, you set up, you know, stores, Walmarts, you know what I'm saying? The Michaels, arts and crafts. Like, why not, man? On the moon. I would live on the moon for like 6 months. I would be cool with that. I'd just be up there looking at Earth like, you bastards. I'm just up here chilling. As long as I got food and music and some movies to watch, let's get it. I'd walk over to the dark side of the moon, see what's over there. What if there was a whole world on the dark side of the moon? Like, who is this we got here? And none of them have even tasted sunlight before. That's a whole nother thing. Anyway, The First Man. It leads up to, you know, Neil Armstrong landing on the moon and like what he was going through with his family and stuff like that. And I thought it was just gonna be a movie where the wife is just like, you putting work before your family. It was deeper than that. Ryan Gosling played it very chill, very bottled up. He wasn't very, you know, talkative about his emotions. It came off a little boring. You know what I'm saying? I wanted him to blow up at least one time. Not blow up on the shuttle takeoff. I mean, just like blow up, like, you know. Cause it's stressful, man. Being an astronaut in the 60s where stuff was just raggedy and uncertain. You know what I'm saying? The computers, the stuff, they were showing like the flight plan on the little TV screen. It looked so low budget. They could be witched. And it was just like, yeah, we gonna circle around. I was like, oh. Imagine putting your life in that. Like, yo, that's what we riding in? Okay. You know, no. And then to do that job, and you see other astronauts, you know, they failing missions, they dying on missions and on test runs. And these are your colleagues, and then you gotta still go. That's a whole nother level of courage of just like ridiculousness. Because if I see the homies, dudes I live across the street from, not making it back, I'm like, man, I don't know if I'm going. Shoot, if I see like a wheel mishap on a Delta Airlines flight, they had to land early because the wheel was broke. I'm like, you know what? I'm not flying this weekend. You know what I'm saying? So props to Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin and them for even having the courage to still even do it. Because man, I couldn't imagine. Space travel? The movie itself was cool. I did like the shots of like, you know, when they were on the rocket, they were showing you from inside the cockpit what it was like to just take off and go into space. I was like, man, that's quite the ride. And you don't really know what's going on outside of the shuttle. That's gotta be terrifying. You seeing flames through the little window. And all you got is like a little window. It's not like a big window where you can look down. You strapped in, so you just like looking. You see flames, what you gonna do? What you gonna do? So I was like, oh man. But other than that, like, it wasn't a lot to the movie that had me like pumped. I was dozing off, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, when they in Houston talking about, you know, what's going on, I don't know what they're talking about. You know what I'm saying? Your altitude dipped below, but you can bounce back up on the undercarriage. And I'm like, what? That's real pilot talk right there. And I couldn't connect. And then he was so bottled up with his emotions, like I couldn't connect on that front. You know what I mean? I was just like, all right, you know. It was well done. Like, I really felt like we were back in the day. Damien is a young director. He's like in his 30s. You know, he wasn't around back in the day. Like, Clint Eastwood was supposed to direct this movie, but I guess he got busy or whatever. So it's like, it's funny getting a young cat to take it back to like the moon landing. Clint Eastwood was there. Clint Eastwood. Shoot, Clint Eastwood has been around so long. He was an established actor then. When they landed on the moon, Clint Eastwood was on set. He got another movie coming out this year, man. Stay working, man. If you find something you love to do, do it until you die. That's what Clint Eastwood is doing. That's what you should all do. Don't stop. Retire for what? Once you retire, you start chilling, and then you die for no reason. You know what I'm saying? Keep working. One takeaway from the movie is Ryan Gosling is good at just being low key all the time. You know what I'm saying? The emotion is internal, guys. You know what I'm saying? It's just the subtle looks on the face, you know, a little smirk here and there. But the rest, you just got to find internal. Cause like, you know, he was just in Blade Runner, you know, 2049. And he was super like chill in that movie. And I was like, Blade Runner was slow as hell. Both of them. Blade Runner and the sequel were just slow. I'm gonna just say it like that. Beautifully shot. But slow as hell. And this movie was slow too. Another takeaway from the movie is they really focused on like the space program and the astronauts. They didn't really go outside of what was going on in America at that time, like, you know, political unrest, the civil rights movement. They gave a glimpse, but they really didn't take it there. They were just like, let's focus on the astronaut in his world. Because I can imagine, like, you know, being Neil Armstrong. Yeah, you see what's going on in the world, but you're a pilot. Like, you putting your life on the line. You got to memorize all this stuff. You're not really focused on, oh, Martin Luther King said what? He's probably not even thinking about that. Like, and not being on some racist stuff, that just wasn't his world. It wasn't in his wheelhouse. So it's like, yo, I got to pilot this shuttle. I don't know what's going on. You know, you get in the bubble. And I feel like the movie had us all in that bubble. It was just like, astronauts, pilots, we trying to get to the moon. That's all you worried about. All right, well, let's do it. So yeah, those are my two takeaways from the film. But forget all that. Y'all want to know the smooth jazz review of First Man? Well, here it is. Oh yeah. I'm giving the First Man 3 saxophones out of 5. What if I just turned around and then I was in the shuttle and I just started taking off and just be shaking and just taking off, just taking the ride? All right, peeps, that's my review of First Man. Let me know what you thought of the movie in the comment section below. Do you want to see it? What'd you think of the trailer? You know what I'm saying? Also, some good space movies, Apollo 13, of course. That's one of the good ones. You want to get on some straight, you know, fantasy sci-fi stuff. I remember Mission to Mars. I remember kind of digging that one. Don Cheadle was in that joint. So check those out if you're into those space travel type joints, man. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and as usual, we out here.